quite unfortunate that we're in a country where somebody who is not qualified to question the certificate of an educated person. I was a Minister of State Education, and I do know that when Oshiomole was in tribunal, we were written. What Oshiomole had was what they call trade test. And trade test is not an academic qualification. Trade test is not an academic qualification. It's like in those days, your parents would tell you to go and learn tailoring, go and do pipeline welding, go and do mechanic. And for you to qualify, for them to say, okay, I've gotten the skill now, they give you trade test. And the simulator cannot say that having a trade test is better than somebody, according to him, who had trade credits. But let us say the simple truth. Assuming, though not considering, that Obasika had three credits. It is the prerogative of the university to admit students in various universities. It is a prerogative. Now, the University of Ibadan has come out to say, this man was our student. This man graduated from our university. It is a non-issue. As far as we are concerned. And this same man, he said, had three credits. He agreed that he was in the brain box. He said, everything he has achieved while in government, that Obaseke was his brain box. Obaseke was the one doing everything. But he couldn't have recorded that achievement without Obaseke. That is the man, he said, that had three credits. A man of three credits became your brain box. A man of three credits made you to achieve what you said you achieved. Now, it's not even better for Edo people to even take a man who had three credits than a man, he said, was a courtist. Than a man, he said, meant a fellow human being that cannot raise children today. It's not better to have three credits than to take the man you said is a fake pastor. Would Edo people not prefer this man that he only had three credits, yet you could make Oshiomole to perform? Would they not prefer to have the man who had three credits, assuming it is correct, than to bring somebody who destroyed his own fellow man and for the man not to have children today? It's not better for Edo people to take a man who had three credits according to Oshiomole than to take a fake pastor, than to take a man who Oshiomole said you cannot trust him with money. Of course, Edo people would prefer to have the man who had three credits than to go and support somebody who nearly killed his own fellow. In fact, don't even kill him. When you have made a man not to have children, that's killing. When you go and to kill other students as a courtist. So, Oshiomole, and if you watch today's campaign, what did the candidate say? Candidate said nothing. Or they win 18 local governments. Everybody spoke to tell you Oshiomole, because of his imperial complex, even talked more than, if you combine what people said by their timing, Oshiomole spoke more than, you know, the man who's won the election did not say anything. So you can see the impunity. Oshiomole is trying to tell Edo people whatever he decides in Edo, that's what's going to be. And it's an opportunity for Edo people to say, no, your own has come to an end. You cannot continue this way. Whether the man had three credits or not, you are the man who said the man was a brain box. Then you cannot give us now the man you said was a courtist, named his fellow student, a man whom he cannot trust with money, and a man who decided as a fake pastor. And you know, as Oshiomole, you know him. Last time in the campaign 2016, he swore in the campaign, he said, in the name of God, in the name of God, he said so. Today again, in the campaign, he started calling about God. He said, we are not violent. I like that to be violent. Now, how can he say they are not violent?
when some candidate, Ize-Iyamu, was caught in a tape arranging with cultists and kidnappers and thugs, when they refer to the lions and the tigers, that they should move from one unit to the other, as against the provisions of the Electoral Act. That in itself is to create violence. And then you are standing on the podium now to call God that people are not violent. Well, your candidate has said, we want to be violent, by telling the thugs and cultists to move from one unit to the other unit. That in itself, you know, it will cause violence. So, Edo people should understand that this so-called rhetoric of Oshiomole, enough is enough. If he likes, he should wear khaki through his lifetime now. We have known him. This khaki came back now because of this election. While he was national chairman of the party, he was wearing safari. He was wearing safari suit, not khaki again. Now, because he's no longer a party chairman, he wants to make us believe that, oh, he's a comrade. He's not any comrade. He's not any comrade. So it is important that they have seen and they know that they cannot win a Edo election. I will not tell you lie. Like I said, Brother Tinubu is one man I have great respect. So when I read the papers today about his comments, I was taken aback. I didn't want to believe that he was not quoted out of context. But let us say, for example, he was not quoted out of context, that was what he said. It would be unfortunate. Now, these were members who were not inaugurated, who were not there to take their oath. It is the governor or the president that proclaims the house. And when you are not there, the governor cannot come to proclaim a house a second time. Right? They did not attend sittings for more than 180 days. The house declared their seats vacant. They went to court. Instead of them to wait for the outcome of the court, they took the laws into their hand by trying to force themselves to the assembly and do what they're supposed to do. And you cannot tell me, as a chief security officer, and I have intelligence, that people want to invade the house, and then I will close my eyes for there to be crisis. No. What the governor did is what any chief security officer should do. People who are not members of the assembly, they may have won election, is different. But having not been inaugurated, you cannot say you're a member of the assembly. And they went to court. The court has not given judgment. Then he took the laws into their hand. Now, where did they go to be inaugurated? In the candidate's house at Benin Jarui. Who will inaugurate you there? Who will inaugurate? And you stay in his house and say you're a suspended speaker. And I saw when the candidate of APC was talking law. It's unfortunate. He didn't go to law school. How can he talk about law? Oshiomole said he didn't go to law school. How can he talk about law? And he could refuse to cite any law that permits him or permits them to hold assembly sitting in his house. It's unfortunate. So I what Obaseki did, justifiable, he would not allow chaos because they are not, as it is today, they are not members of the state assembly of Edo State because they were not inaugurated. And since you're not, and the house has already, whether wrongly or rightly, declared their seat vacant, or declared their seats vacant, and you have gone to court to challenge the declaration of your seat vacant, then you must wait for the outcome of the court, and not for you to take laws into your hand, simply because you have security. And that's what I've said, and what I've told my colleagues, that look, the crisis in Nigeria, these elections you see, crisis we're having will always come from security agencies. And it is not obvious. And they said, oh, that the president endorsed him. It's unfortunate. How can people say the president endorsed him? President is a member of his party. On the 25th of June, when they had their neck, president said, we have ratified the primaries. So what is it endorsing him now? There's no endorsement. Rather, President knows fully well that that rally, he cannot go and speak for anybody to vote for him because he faced corruption charges. Why didn't the vice president come? Why didn't the president come? Did they give flag in president's office? I mean, common sense will tell you that that's not an endorsement. What the president did was practical. Because I don't want anything to affect my integrity. Well, it is party issue. And if we don't give you flag, what will happen? The time for changing or substituting candidate is over. So they're not going to go on all the screens, president endorses. So many people who collected form of APC, they go to see Mr. President, and they post with the form with Mr. President. I can't do, did it. The governorship aspirant in Adamawa, who is president-in-law, he bought the form and went to see president, and he just snapped it in. So that all those is an endorsement. No, let them tell us where president spoke. I say, I'm hereby endorsing you. Let them show all the video where president said, I'm hereby endorsing you. That's about propaganda. Yes, you want to see president, oh, let's present a flag, since you're not being the rally. Then you come out and tell the press that the president has endorsed. It took them time, even it took them weeks before president agreed to even see him. All these things are political things that they are doing, we know. But the point remains that a lot of people know Oshiomole cannot continue to ride them, continue to think that they're not intelligent, continue to think that somebody who had a trade test certificate should be the one directing we professors and doctors, graduates, on what to do. No, it's not going to be possible. The man, he said, had 3 credits. The man went to university, admit me, for example. University in their own wisdom admitted him. You know too, they were called remedial courses. Probably that, I assume it is correct. The university was like, okay, you have to do 1 year remedial. That now qualifies you to assuming. But assuming he didn't even do that. But the university said, yes, 3 credits, we will admit you. After all, there are so many universities. Before, there's nothing like you must have credit in mathematics before you did law. But now, you must have credit in mathematics. So assuming now you come up, you say, look, the qualification is I must have credit at my time to read law. This thing changes. It changes because the criteria today will change in the next few years. So it is not as if it is static. People before, no mathematics, no credit in mathematics before you read law. Now you must have a credit in mathematics. There are some universities who will say, look, seeing you, will take you, will think you will do better. What is important is, did the university admit him? Yes. If the university admitted him wrongly, whose business is that? Whose business is that? So it is not there. And two, people make a lot of noise about court. Yes, Oshiomole can say so, because they believe they own the court. They believe they have somewhat threatened the court that anything they say, that's what the court will do. Because no person comes out in the public and said, we'll win in court. They know they will not win on ground. So their own hope now is they will use the court. But we still know, no matter how it is, there are still some judges and justices who have conscience, whom you cannot manipulate. We do know that. So Oshiomole coming out to the public to say, we will win in court. The court is not Oshiomole's court. The court is not his mother's court. So he cannot threaten anybody that he will win in court. We'll first of all win him on ground. Then we'll join him in that court, he's saying. And then let us see how the court will be used by Oshiomole to his own wills and caprices. Anyhow he wants it, let the court listen to Oshiomole. I mean, this country is something that you can't even understand it. A man has no certificate. A man is challenging certificate for another. Can Oshiomole come out and tell the world, I went to school, look at my certificate. Look at my certificate. I challenge Oshiomole. Come out and say, Nigerians, this issue of me not going to school is getting too much. This thing that I have only three tests I'm getting is getting too much. Look at, I went to this current school, look at my result. A tailor in those days, you went to learn how to do the tailoring. Is that academic qualification? It's not. So he has no moral obligation. He has no moral duty to say that Abaseki had three credits and therefore Edo people should not vote him for a man who had three credits. A graduate of a premier university and a man who had three credits that was brain box, whom he said, without Obaseki, I would not have achieved what I achieved. So he thinks that he tells people, he says one thing here today, he says a different thing. Edo people are aware. If Oshiomole was good, how would his own world chairman suspend him? If Oshiomole was that good, if Oshiomole was that popular, is your own world chairman will suspend you. And the court upheld it. Technically, even Oshiomole cannot claim to be a chairman of the party. Technically, I mean, cannot claim to be a member of APC. So he just didn't know those things to do. When a man has a problem, he tries to place the amusement, tries to make people, he becomes a comedian in order to divert attention. But this one, he cannot divert attention. Thank you.